welcome back. It is our week 8 of Skin Games, and it's our final week here. And so this is our result week. This week, we wanted to go in and just kind of get Chelsea's skin on track, get it nice and exfoliated, make it really bright, really clarifying for her pictures today. So what we did is she was having a little bit of dry skin come up just because she's still healing from the microneedling. So we went in and did a light dermaplane and then a mint papaya enzyme. Just like I said earlier this in the series, it's like a little Pac-Man chomping away at all of her dead skin, giving her a nice polished look, really hydrating the skin. And we went in lastly with my favorite, the Circadia Oxygen Treatment. Creating a controlled amount of oxygen on the skin is really killing all of her bacteria, especially some of these active breakouts that she is having still, just because her skin is normally acneic. It's gonna happen, even during this journey and afterwards. So we want to make sure, even though we're ending the Skin Games journey, it's still amplifying her treatment, healing that collagen, calming down the redness, and giving her just the skin resurfacing. So since it's week 8 and it is our final reveal, my main thing that I want to know is kind of about Chelsea.
Well, at first I did have a lot of anxiety considering that I've always had a problem with my skin. So going into something new, changing your diet, at home care, it's kind of a lot to take in, so you kind of have to take a step back and just look at the bigger picture of things.
10 products.
Yes. And so really it was kind of more... It was harder for me to change my diet because I'm a Dr. Pepper fiend. I always have been. So, you know. And then I cut out a lot of bread too, so that kind of helped, I feel like.
We can really see that because we know that everything going into the body is going to come out on the skin. Your skin is your largest organ. So when she was having, you know, some of her breakouts on her neck and her chest, I realized there's something going in, you know, obviously her diet-wise that we needed to cut out. And just through even the first 4 weeks, we could see just the clear complexion on her chest and those active bad boys just calming down, like a lot.
A lot of people at work have made compliments about how they can tell the texture of my skin because I'm really close friends with a lot of people that I work with, so they kind of know that I've always had a problem with it.
And that was my next question for you. I wanted to see, like, when did you start realizing the change? When did you kind of, in the healing process, see those results?
Honestly, probably right after our first time. Because it kind of took a lot of that texture and evened it out a little bit. And so hearing from my coworkers itself that, you know, they could see a difference and then I could see it on top of it just made me feel a lot better about, you know, I sit in front of people all day long and I'm at the front desk. So it makes me feel better in hearing that other people can tell that they see a difference as well. And so that felt really good.
Awesome. So microneedling, guys, it's awesome. It changes lives. It changes skin. It sounds scary, but it's awesome. So Chelsea, thank you for being such an amazing cooperative model. She was here. She was using her home care. Her diet was on point. So thank you for being just amazing. This was so nervous for me, and just having her as a model made it all better. So again, everyone watching Circadia, Lightstim, and Hydrafacial, thank you so much for being sponsors and really helping the skin journey with Chelsea. And it was amazing, and I loved it, and we will be back next year. So, bye guys!